हेलो, वेलकम टू जसलन सिविल। दिस इज द सेकेंड ट्यूटोरियल इन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। वी विल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट आर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टेंडर डॉक्यूमेंट एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट डॉक्यूमेंट। कॉन्ट्रैक्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्स आर दोज डॉक्यूमेंट्स व्हिच आर साइंड बाय बोथ द पार्टीज, द एम्प्लॉयर एंड द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर। And when they sign, that becomes the contract document. Most of the contract documents are imported from the tender document. And tender document is the document which is used or which is prepared during the invitation of the tender. Tender document is prepared by public entity, but signed by only the public entity, not by the contractor. Now let's see what are the tender documents in priority order. The first is the invitation for bid, that is the notice. Tender notice contains the informations like when the tender will open, what is the amount of the tender, and what are some of the conditions, who can apply for tender or who are eligible for to apply the tender, how much bid bond or bid security and other informations related to are given in summary in tender notice. Then we will have instruction to bidders. This is the instruction given to the bidders. Bidders are those who apply for the tender. The instruction includes how to fill the bid document or how to apply for the bid document, what are the meaning of the words used in the bid document. Those are the instructions given to the bidders. What are the documents to be submitted, in what format the documents will be submitted, and so on. Now the bid data sheet. Based on the instruction to bidders, the bid data sheet is prepared. Bid data sheet contains the name of the public entity, when the bid is to be opened, when the bid is to be issued, when the pre-bid meeting shall be held, and so on. So it is this bid data sheet is to be filled by the public entity. Instruction to bidders is left as it is in the format. No change in the instruction to bidders is done from the standard bidding document. But bid data sheet varies from one public entity to another public entity, one project of the same public entity to another project of the same public entity. Evaluation and eligibility criteria. Evaluation and eligibility criteria contains the criteria which is to be fulfilled by the bidder to be eligible to be evaluated for the bid. The evaluation criteria may include like you have to submit tax document, business registration, form registration, nationality, have you ever been declared ineligible by any government or UN agencies, and so on. So if those criteria are fulfilled, how to evaluate and who will be eligible is based on this evaluation and criteria document. Now bidding forms. Bidding forms contains bidding forms, work requirement, bill of quantities. We will see what those values contains, these bidding forms and work requirement in detail later. Now bill of quantities. Bill of quantities means BOQ. This is prepared by the public entity. The rate is not mentioned. Only quantities are mentioned. Here will be description of items, then we will have quantities and unit of quantities. Like for earthwork we will have suppose 2 cubic meter, and then rate is left blank. This is to be filled by the contractor. So this is our bill of quantities, and in the total we will have subtotal, then VAT 13%, and then grand total by adding these two. So that will be our contract price. And the lowest of all the bidders who have the lowest contract price will be awarded the contract, given that he is eligible. Now conditions of contract and then contract forms. This is the bidder forms. Bidder forms contains these following four documents: letter of bid, price adjustment table, bid security guarantee, bidder's information or JV information. JV means joint venture. You can apply as an individual or in joint venture. The number of the partners in the joint venture is mentioned in the bid data set, which can be maximum up to 3. Letter of bid contains the format where the bidders declare how much percentage discount will they offer in the BOQ price. Suppose BOQ price is 100 and they offer 10% below BOQ discount in letter of bid, then the actual BOQ would be 90. So this will be the contract price. 90 will be the contract price. And letter of bid contains others like the conditions, such as they have not been declared ineligible by any government offices, and what is the bidding amount, and so on. This is contained in the letter of bid. And price adjustment table is to be prepared by the public entity. Now price adjustment table contains, like, suppose the project is multi-year project, like 2 years, 3 years, 4 years project, and the price adjustment includes the inflation. Suppose cement price is now 800 rupees per bag, then later it don't remain the same, so you can do the price adjustment from based on this table. Now bank guarantee. This is the bid security. While submitting bid, you have to present the bank guarantee of the bid. It is generally 2 to 3% of the estimated amount, and the bidders need to submit the bank guarantee or in cash form. If they need to submit in cash form, they will simply deposit in the account of the office. But if they will deposit bid guarantee, then the bank will prepare a guarantee which is submitted to the public entity. And bidders information or JV information like name, address, year of constitution, and so on are contained in this information. Work requirement contains scope of the work, like what works needs to be done. Suppose a building needs to be constructed, or suppose a hospital needs to be constructed, or a school, then there may be canteen block or other blocks, RCC work, PCC, brick work, or steel work, and what works are to be performed. In a summary, this is specified in scope of work. Specifications means how the measurement shall be taken, what are the specifications of the materials that is to be used, are specified in the specifications. You can find the standard specifications from the website of the government agencies who prepares the specifications, like the size of the brick, the quality of cement, the measurement length should be measured nearest to how many decimal digits, and so on. Drawing is prepared by the public entity and attached in the tender document so that the bidders can make their own estimate and prepare the rate for themselves. And any supplementary information regarding this work requirement is to be supplied here. Conditions of contract. General conditions of contract is already available in the standard bid document, so we don't need to change the general conditions of contract, which is GCC in short form. And special conditions of contract are some of the changes made to the general conditions of contract that varies from project to project. Special conditions of contract includes how much performance bond is to be deposited by the successful bidders, when the work will start, when the work will end, how the payment shall be made in the running bills and the final bills, or how the advance payment shall be made, and so on. These are specified in the special conditions of contract, which are simply the modification of general conditions of contract. In case there is dispute over general conditions of contract, the special conditions of contract is given first priority in contract document. This is tender document. Now, contract forms is also attached in the SBD, standard bidding document. The first is the letter of intent. It is issued to all the past bidder who have successfully passed the eligibility criteria. Then after 7 days, letter of acceptance is given. This is issued to all, but name of only the successful bidder is mentioned. and letter of acceptance is given to the successful bidders only, not to the all, only the one who have been accepted. So within 15 days after the acceptance of the letter of acceptance, they need to contract with the office. Contract agreement is the document where both the parties, the contractor and the employer, signs the document, and there is the list of the document which needs to be submitted to make the contract. Performance security is, it is also like the bid guarantee, but this is of higher amount, like 5 to 10% range, and it is calculated based on the BOQ filled by the contractor, the contract price of the lowest evaluated bidder. And the advance payment security, so initially we can give the advance payment of 5%, 10%. For that they need to present APG. It is also a bank guarantee of the same amount the advance is to be issued. These were the tender documents. Now let's see contract document. Most of the contract documents are imported from the tender document. The first is the contract agreement, which we already saw. This is in priority order. The second is the letter of acceptance. It is also from the tender document, but prepared after the successful bidder has been selected. Letter of bid, we already saw it. It was present in the bidding forms. Then the addendas number. Suppose while issuing tender, if any additional document is again uploaded or issued related to this tender, then that also becomes the part of the contract. That is the addendas. Additional document, addendas. Now special conditions of contract is given the first priority. Then list of eligible countries. So if it is national level, then this is not required, because only the national level will be able to bid. But if it is international level contract, then you have to specify which countries are eligible to bid, and those countries list needs to be attached in the contract document as well. General conditions of contract. Then in 8 number, the specifications which we saw in work requirement, the drawing, bill of quantities. Bill of quantities is the BOQ filled by the successful bidder. Only that is attached here. Table of price adjustment to include the effect of inflation of price of materials. Now list of approved subcontractors. So if the tender document specifies that subcontractor can be used, then the bidder will specify which subcontractors shall be from their side, and the office will finalize the list of those approved subcontractors. Thank you for watching. Comment for any further question, click the bell icon for notification.